Okay, so for today's quick little project, I'm going to show you how to make these lovely little shabby flowers. Really, really quick and easy. But they are so pretty, really, really pretty. And I want to make them because I want to make a nice shabby wreath. So I thought I'd make these first and show you how I do it. So what I've done, I have to get a base, which is this here. So I'm going to cut out this. I was lucky enough to be given a whole big bunch of fabric samples. So I'm just using a couple of them, just use as the base of my flowers. I will be doing some projects with them because I have got loads and loads of them. So I'm just going to cut the base out like that. Okay. I'll pop those over there. So what I did, I've got a, it's not quite like muslin, it's a bit thicker, but it's a very, very light cotton. But so it frays really easy, so you can really shabby it up and it makes it look really, really pretty. So I've just cut up, it was an old curtain, very, very light curtain, so it was nice. So what I do, I just, it's not a square, it's more of a sort of rectangle, and it all depends on what size you want your flowers to be, depending on what size you cut them up. So these are just roughly cut, so I've just don't quite fold them in half, and then just sort of like roughly fold like that, and then we take a little bit of glue in there and stick it down. So what we want six of these, sorry. This is to go on the outside, and then I want four of the little ones to go in the middle. So I've cut a whole big bunch of them, so I'm going to just quickly do six of these. You just take it, fold it sort of that way, and then so the sort of point goes into the middle, and then just pop a bit of glue in the middle so it doesn't unravel. Make sure you get glue everywhere. So obviously you can use any fabric you like, anything you've got. You can even make these out of paper. So here, if you have a nice little paper project you want to do, or pop them on cards, you can do this as well. So how many have we got there? So two, four, one more. Fold it in half and then fold it into the middle and pop a little bit of glue on there. Oops. A bit of the glue. So and then we're going to do a smaller one. So we just want four of these. So the same again, fold it over into the middle. Fold it in the middle so you've got sort of like an endy bit there. So it makes it all rusticky. Pop it over. Pop that in the middle. Hold it down so it sticks. Top it there. Okay, last one. Okay, so we'll take our little circle. You can cut this out of anything, you can even cut this out of paper if you want to. So what I do, I take the six big ones, so pop a little bit of glue on there. You want to aim for near enough into the middle. Then I sort of try and put one either side, so opposite each other, like that. And then I pop that one so it sort of like folds into the flap there. This one on. So folds in there. That's perfect. Like that. Oops. There we go. upside one, and the same again with the little ones. So I'll put that on that side. Again, I go opposite. If you wanted them smaller, obviously you cut the squares smaller, or you can just do all of it with the small ones. And what I do is just sort of like scrunch it all up, rough it up, so you get all the little bits coming off the end. That's the bottom of it, so it's all nice and shabby. Pop that in there, and then I take one of these and pop it in the middle. I'll just show you. This is just some seam binding, and I've doubled this one over. I've just put two pieces on there, but what I'm going to show you now is just how to do one, just a single layer. If you want multiple layers, you just put one layer on top of the other like that and sew it. So let's have a look. I'm going to do it in a black thread so you can see what I'm doing. I've just tied a knot in the end. I don't cut the length, so then we can, it depends how long you want it. If you want it bigger, then you can use a little bit more. I just, oopsie daisy, just double over the end like that so it doesn't come out, and then I just do like a little up and down stitch. Then I'm not a sewer, so I haven't got a clue. You just go up and down, and I'll probably do this probably about 12, 15 times, which makes a nice flower. Then you just pop it through. A little bit more. I wasn't counting, so up and down. There we go. Oops. One of the quickest ones I've ever done, easiest and most effective. So then you put the two ends together like that, fold that over the little end bit, just pull that tight, and then just sew the two end bits together. So I hope that made sense. There we go. And you've got your little flower. Chop that little end bit out there. That looks like a little flower centre. So let's chop this off here. And there we go. And these are lovely because they're so small and so light. You can put them on your cards as well. So that one, I just put the two in there. Perfect, so that's how I did those. Pop that to the side. Put the cotton over there. So then we just shabby this up like that. Pop that in the middle and a little bit of glue. Like so, and then I've got lovely little crystal gems here, which I thought I would pop into the middle. There we go. Very, very quick and effective. So there we go. Perfect. Well, I hope you like that quick little project. I will be showing you what I use these for. I will be popping them onto a wreath I will be making in my next video. So please join me on that. And if you do like what I do, please subscribe to my channel. And a big thumbs up would be great. And I hope you'll join me next time. Thank you. Bye bye.